very good morning to our viewers. I am Dr. Ala Singh and I welcome you all to your favorite show, Krishi Darshan. Krishi Darshan always brings new topics with latest information for the farmers. Today, we are going to discuss about participatory plant breeding. Participatory plant breeding is a new approach where farmers themselves are involved in the breeding process and they play a role in the development of newer crop varieties. I have with me a panel of experts who come from diverse backgrounds and will try to have a holistic picture of plant breeding from them. I have Dr. Anas KK, Principal Scientist, Division of Genetics, Indian Agricultural Research Institute, New Delhi. He has 10 years of experience in the field of participatory plant breeding. Dr. Amit Kumar, Division of Agronomy, Central Institute of Agronomy, Mumbai. He has 15 years of experience in the field of agronomical practices. Dr. Anindita Datta, Principal Scientist, Indian Agricultural Statistics Research Institute, New Delhi. She has 12 years of experience in the field of statistical practices. Dr. Anil Patidar, Principal Scientist, National Bureau of Plant Genetic Resources. He has 10 years of experience in plant genetic resources. Dr. Alok Kumar, Principal Scientist, Directorate of Seed Research, Mau. He is a national professor and is involved in the fields of seed production and maintenance breeding. And finally, Dr. Ambrish P. Gope, Principal Scientist and Head, Agricultural Extension, Indian Agricultural Research Institute, New Delhi. He has 20 years of experience in the field of agricultural extension services. So first, I would like to ask Dr. Anas, so please tell us, why do we need participatory plant breeding?
Thank you, Dr. Singh. Whenever formal breeding practices fails, efforts must be undertaken to employ participatory plant breeding. Participatory plant breeding involves small-scale farmers of marginalized region more intimately into the development of genetic material which is suitable for local communities. The challenges for participatory plant breeding is to focus on traits that have not been addressed in plant breeding so far. For example, mixed cropping. Again, it is important to focus on crops where choices of varieties are limited. For example, cash crops and other local crops. This is where we require participatory plant breeding.
Thank you, Dr. Nas. You commented very precisely on the need of participatory plant breeding. Now, I would like to ask Dr. Anil, so please elaborate on the exact role of farmers in participatory approaches.
Thank you, Dr. Singh. Farmers play a very important role in participatory plant breeding because they conserve land races and variety of the crop plant on their farm. And these land races are genetically diverse. They are well adapted to local condition. They are bred, cultivated and maintained by the farmer from generation to the generation. It is also important to highlight the institute like NBBGR, which play an important role in preservation of a number of farmers' variety in seed gene bank as well as in field gene bank. It is also important to note that farmers have right to breed, to develop and to register their own varieties as per Section 39 of Protection of Plant Varieties and Farmer Right Act 2001. So farmer is the most important component of participatory plant breeding.
Thank you, Dr. Anil, for the information. Dr. Amit, can you please tell us what could be the possible role of agronomy in the conduction of participatory plant breeding related trials?
Thank you, Dr. Singh. Basically, agronomy depends on the principle that we have to give a favorable environment to the crop. Say, for example, we are going to take a participatory trial in which the objective is to select a cultivar suitable for SRI method of rice cultivation. In this, we have to abide by the principles of SRI, that are transplanting of seedling that is of very young age at the rate of single seedling per hill under the puddled conditions and in the square planting. Secondly, we have to go for nutrient management which is to be done through the organic as well as inorganic sources in equal ratio. Thirdly, water management, for which we have to go for alternate wetting and drying of the field. And lastly, the weed management practice, which is one of the most important. For this, we are using cono weeder. So if in this trial we are avoiding any of these principles, as well as if we are not taking observation properly, then we can end up with the wrong selection of variety for the participatory trial.
Thank you, Dr. Amit, for your recommendations on following the package of practices to get the right results. Dr. Alok, please tell us that how can the varieties that are obtained in the participatory approaches be integrated with the seed production channels?
Thank you, Dr. Singh. I think this is a very valuable question for the farmer, because without introducing any varieties into the seed production channel, we can't really harvest the real endeavor of the farmers as well as the breeder. In any varieties, first we take a few kilograms of nucleus seeds and then produce breeder seeds in the supervision of the respective breeders, and then foundation seeds, and then lastly certified seeds in the different station of the National Seed Corporation and ICR Institute. And these certified seeds then go to the farmer fields with proper seed testing and tagging. Therefore, the varieties developed by the farmers by participatory plant breeding will definitely go into the seed production channel. In Seed Act 1966, there is the provision for the truthfully labeled seeds, in which anybody can sell their seeds on their own responsibility in market, in which they have to satisfy the minimum germination percentage and moisture content, physical purity, and if these are hybrids, then genetic purity is the must. Therefore, the farmers developed varieties by participatory plant breeding will definitely go into the market, and the farmer earns profitable amount.
Thank you, Dr. Alok, for this information on seed certification. Now, Dr. Anandita, please highlight the importance of statistics in plant breeding for the benefit of our farmers.
Yes, Dr. Singh. Statistics may be, some basic knowledge about statistics may be helpful to the farmer to get more precise results. Depending upon different experimental situation, various designs like randomized block design, split plot, strip plot, and lattice design can be used by proper consultation of a statistician. Suppose there is one-way heterogeneity in the experimental material, then a farmer can go for randomized block design. As depicted in the picture, a layout of a randomized block design with 5 varieties in 2 replication is given. Thus, by using simple concept of statistics, a farmer can get more fruitful result.
Thank you, Dr. Anandita.